the speed stuff doesn't really happen until now, which is like the end of the program, which is the last month of the summer program. So now we're starting to get into a lot of the speed stuff, and that's what we're about to do today. We got some 30 meter flies. Even though I haven't been doing a whole lot of track work, I feel really great. The few times that I have touched the track have all been great. Like the first time I tried to touch the track after the little break they give us off season, it was I had a lot of pain, a lot of discomfort. I still had a lot of injuries, or not injuries, but like discomforts and knickknacks I was dealing with, so it was hard for me to really open up and actually benefit from the track. So I took some more time off, and now I'm starting to feel a lot better. I actually feel way stronger and way more stable than I was during the in season. We gotta back up a little bit here. But yeah, I'm gonna get very nerdy in this video. Y'all gonna hear me yap for real. Most of the time I kinda give y'all tips and advice in my videos, but like through text, but this is when I'm gonna actually like talk things out and explain things. Yeah, I get to do that in today's video, so I'm a little bit excited about that. But today, we got flies. We have a 20 meter buildup, which is from there over to here into a 30 meter fly. And just some speed work. It doesn't have to be anything insanely fast. We'll be in this middle lane, but just getting good quality of movement, good reps, and just to feel good. We're not gonna time ourselves, I wish, but I don't have a timing system, so we're just, everything's just gonna go off of purely feeling. And if they feel really fast, and that's good. If they feel really, really fast, that's good, because we're still technically in the off season. So if I'm still fast in the off season, now imagine when I get back in season, you know? I have to be exactly precise, just, okay. So if I didn't explain it already, it's a 20 meter buildup into a 30 meter fly. It's like a drop in 20. So I'm gonna do like a running start and into the 30. But first thing first, we gotta warm up. So I made a video explaining my kind of warm up process for like practice. This kind of the warm up stuff that we do in practice. So you guys should go check that out. I will be making a competition warm up once competition season starts, like how I kind of warm up for my competition to compete, because that's a little different, just the way I go about that. But first things first, we got a 1 minute or a one lap jog. I gotta listen to music. I know a lot of people have like, my coaches be getting on me all the time, but I have to listen to music because that's just how I get in my zone. That's how I vibe. Hey, right now we listening to Gunna. Y'all gotta type in with Gunna, bro. Man, y'all already know Gunna the GOAT, bro.
I've been getting it since a toddler. I keep dollars on my head. Been a real one, is my motto. Handle my problems, I ain't scared. I put powder on my collar, cause she proud of what I said. I'm a leader, I got on follow, and my footsteps like the feds. I shoot like I'm Montana, chop up bullets, make them shit. Black on black, new phantom in the backseat, sipping red. Jump from Atlanta with these hoes ready like pig. Condo like the pharmacy, I got codeine in my fridge. My bro on a steaming stove, cooking crack like grits. Got this vibe on a tippy toe, struggling in a pit. LA Live, I'm staying at the lows with this Hollywood bitch. Got a nine in the snow, no, can't wait to let it hit. Pull up with a stink, I pull up with a stink. I pull up with a pink tone, with me she sucking it. I put some diamonds on her toes, let her hold on to them reach. We was used to pulling kick those, you can still call it a leak. Broken can be fixed, with the memes is spent the nick. How you pull that don't make sense, I made a whole mile off an inch. I had 99 problems, I just scratch your heart to this. Got some knees and winning, salt on my neck, cause a quarter brick. I've been getting it since a toddler, I keep dollars on my head. Been a real one, is my motto, handle my problems, I ain't scared. I put powder on my collar, cause she proud of what I said. I'm a nigga, I got on follow, and my footsteps like the bitch.
My hips are a bit tight. But I haven't, that's just cause I haven't done fast. I haven't gone fast in like that long in a while. But that's the warm up. Now I'm gonna get in spikes and start it. See these? Hypercarbon CP2. Sprint bikes. From Jack's Bike Co. Use code Tarnue for 10% off. These are better than Max Flies, trust me. And they sexy too. Look at that colorway. Look at that. I already mentioned in the video that I was gonna be using these for my whole season, for as long as they take me. And I'm gonna buy more. Cause I'm done with Max Flies, bro. I have 3 pairs of Max Flies. Gone through 3 of them. They all broke on me. The bubble popped. They hurt my feet. These, comfortable, breathable, and they still sturdy and get the job done. So, why not? They a little cheaper than Max Flies too. So, and if you use my code Tarnue for 10% off, that's like another $15, $20 off. Like, okay, so we got 4 of these. I don't know how much the rest is. We're gonna say like 5-6 minutes. We'll do 5 minutes. Okay. Oh. All right, first rep. This sprinting stuff, it's not fun. Once you start doing it correctly, it hurts. Like you're concentrating on every single muscle fiber in your body, bro. To make sure everything's as efficient as possible. It's taxing. But that's what you get, 5-minute rest. But that felt good though. Felt very plyometric. Which is good. That basically means that I was just very bouncy. Which is good, but I wanna avoid being too vertical, because that's the habit that I have. I spent too much time in the air. Because I'm just so stiff and smooth. I get into these very tall cycles and I don't go forward with it. So my coach has been trying to get me to get the most out of every step and really put the track behind me when I'm upright like that. Cause it looks clean, it looks cute, it looks pretty, but it's not efficient in getting me towards the finish line. It's just, AJ looked good, but that's what we're working on today. That's why I said it was like taxing, cause I'm concentrating on here and I'm concentrating on here, 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 and here, and then here, for both legs, while arms, while telling myself to continue to push, like, it's taxing. That's why I don't do so well in the 100 or the 60, because I get bored, I get lazy. It's a lot of energy, a lot of effort, and I want to just relax. Like a 200 or 400, I want to just coast, but gotta continue to be aggressive, as my AAU coach Eric Garcia would say. Gotta continue to be aggressive. So it's taxing neurologically too. Nice little 5-minute break though. This is a good point. If this is on YouTube, subscribe. If this is on Instagram, follow. If it's on TikTok, follow. Yeah. Get with me. Like, follow, subscribe, do all that. That's the thing with sprinting, you gotta like prime yourself. Whew! I'm such a lazy sprinter, bro. I don't wanna keep sprinting. It's just so about like halfway through, I was like, oh my. And I completely relaxed. The way I relax is like when you're in a car and you're like accelerating and you're building up and then you just take your foot off the brake and you slowly deaccelerate. That's how I do. You're not supposed to do it that way. But I'm just so like lazy because it's so taxing, you know? So I gotta learn how to keep my foot on the gas. That makes sense. But it was good though, like you can tell a sprinter was sprinting fast if it takes them a long time to slow down. And even though this is only 50 meters, I went all the way through the 100 because I was deaccelerating. That means that's good. That's a lot of momentum that I'm carrying. But it's just taxing, bro. But I gotta get used to it because I have this habit of slowing down before the line. Like when I get here, I'm on my last stride, I like shut down. I gotta learn how to go all the way through. Cause I'm not, although I'm a sprinter in high school, I did the 400 a lot. So it was a lot of push, 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 and coast for a good 250. Or yeah, 250. And then re-accelerate on that last one, 150. So it was just, it's all about like retraining those patterns. But yeah, bro, it's hard. Sprinting is hard. So hard. But once you understand it and it becomes subconscious, you're good. You're good. Like my acceleration pattern, subconscious. I could do that easy as hell. Like, you know, it's habitual at this point. But top speed work, that's where I suffer from a lot. Cause again, I just like to coast and sit instead of maintaining what I got going on. But yeah, these spikes, mad comfortable. I just tied them a little too tight, but these are mad comfortable. Something I was talking about in the video I did with LB, who's a D1 sprinter from the U, was, cause she was talking about how she went D1. And with her, basically she said, oh, that was kind of natural. Her coach saw her running one day in basketball and was like, come do track, you know? And she stuck with it. She was just gifted at that, you know? She was just fast. But guys like me, super slow, super underdeveloped, super skinny. I had to like work to get to this position. So, and I was talking about like how like, in a way, I'm like an advocate for those of you guys who are like, who are in the position I was in, where you're on the track team, but you're not selected to be on the 4x1 because you're not the fastest, you know? Where the girls are running faster than you, or you're out of breath, or, you know, you just want to get faster. You feel super weak, super slow. You just want to get faster. And like, although I troll a lot on my videos and stuff like that, but you can see I was rolled as hell. Like, it was bad. But I wanted it so bad, and I'm here now, you know? But this isn't the end, though. I want to get to the point where I'm at that top level. I'm an advocate for you guys, so you guys can see that because I was able to do it, you guys can too, you know? And when I tell you I was rolled, man, 14 second 100, 30 second 200, like it was bad. So a lot of people ask me all the time, like, oh, is 11.8 fast for a freshman? Oh, is 12.2 fast for a freshman? Bro, I was running 14 seconds. And 30 seconds, like, and a minute 10 for the 400, like, you know? You guys are in a good spot, trust. I was way worse. It does not get worse than me, I promise you that. And now look at me. I promise y'all, bro, I'm going 10-2, 10-1, 10-1, 10-2 this year. And y'all gonna see that. Anything's possible, bro, you're limitless. That's the doctrine, that's the mindset my coach instilled into me, that's the mindset I'm instilling to myself. Maintaining within myself, and that's the mindset I'm trying to instill in y'all. Y'all can do anything. And I don't mean to get super corny, super sentimental, but man, as long as you got God controlling the uncontrollables and you got a strong determination and hunger to control the controllables, you're chilling. You're in the right spot, trust. Okay, third rep. I That was fast. Hey man, special shout out to these guys, bro. I can't do that no more. All that running, after what I just did, and then to turn around and go back again, and with a ball. Man, so I just stick to track. A straight line, sometimes a curve. Sometimes a curve or two, but. Nah, but that one was good though. That was good. We got one more rep. Another thing too is summer training, like, it allows you room to breathe. Like, if at all, something don't feel right, shut it down. If you didn't eat enough, sleep enough, drink enough, shut it down. You know, you have, it's grace, essentially. Like, summer is supposed to be there for you to touch up on the skills to raise your ceiling or raise your flooring a little bit. So when you go into fall training, you have a higher ceiling, you know? You're up a couple stories to then continue building, you know? So, for example, the beginning of summer, had knee problems. My knee was still stiff. On like the second or third rep, shut it down and didn't do nothing. And that's okay, because you want to take care of yourself. You don't want to blow a flat tire, you know? And that's a good analogy too. Your body's like a car, like a used car. You know, the older you are, or the longer you've been doing this sport, the more worn out your parts are gonna be. And that's where you can start to get injuries, or you start to do stupid stuff with your car. Your check engine light comes on. You know, you pull something, your knee has issues. And just like how you go to a mechanic to get it tweaked on or worked on, you go to your trainer, all that. So think of your body as like a used car. What's the point of trying to drive on a flat tire? Oh, you know your tire pressure is low. Why are you driving? Why are you going on a road trip when your check engine light is on, you know? Why are you trying to do street racing when you need to get your oil changed? You know? It don't hurt to take your car to the shop every once in a while. It's just taking care of yourself. That's really it. Even during the end season, a lot of people want to try. A lot of people are like me. I try to ignore my injuries and hope they'll go away, because I haven't had any serious severe injuries yet to the point where it stops anything. But I'll get knee issues, hip issues. I'll keep trying to push through it. But you got to take calm down and go to the mechanic, bro. Go to the shop. Just take care of yourself. And also my strength coach likes to say, why are you trying to do a workout on an empty stomach or a lack of sleep when your battery is low or your fuel is low? You're not gonna be as efficient, you know? Because I used to show up to workouts hungry as hell, no food, dehydrated. I thought I had heart problems because I'll go to practice, no food, no water, and I'll be like passing out, damn near passing out during my workouts. We all thought I had heart issues. I couldn't compete for like 2 months, but all I need to do was eat and drink water a good few hours before practice. So it's just simple stuff like that. The Olympic standards, they get faster and faster each year. So this past year for the 100, it was like 10 flat. You gotta be under 10 flat. So Joe, he ran like 9 something. Matadi ran 9 something. No, Joe's doing the 200, my bad. Joe went like 10-0 something. But you gotta go 10-0, and I think you gotta go 20.1 or 19, so I don't remember. But
what's your
21.6 as of right now. So it's a long way to go, but I'm gonna let y'all in on a secret though. I've been talking to Team Liberia. Keep that a little secret. But no, yeah, that'll be lit though. By God's grace, that'll be lit. Oh, I thought I'm about to pass out. That's how you know you're sprinting.
when after the rep, you feel lightheaded and like you're about to pass out. But that's the workout. Now we got a cool down. Y'all gotta do a cool down after every workout. That's how you take care of your body. That was fast. That was fast. Opera did that. That was probably like a 2.9, 2.99, 2.98, 30 split. Had to have been. Sprinting is hard work, bro. These did me good today. I already know I'm gonna get these dirty, bro. But I'm probably gonna be washing them a lot because these are so tough. Again, Hypercarbon CP2 Sprint Spikes from Track Spikes Co. Use code Tarnue for 10% off. Help me out a little bit, you know, I'm broke. Let me get a little something, something, but. All right, this is my cool down routine. That. Make sure I like and subscribe, follow. That's really that. You're limitless. God bless.